Meanwhile, over in Statesboro, folks getting pretty pumped about the return of Georgia Southern baseball. The Eagles kicking off the new campaign against 19th-ranked Tennessee next weekend out at J.I. Clement Stadium. Our Amy Zimmer has more from the Eagles as excitement begins to build in the borough.
After having the 2020 season canceled due to the pandemic, Georgia Southern baseball ready to take care of unfinished business. March 12, 2020, a day Georgia Southern will never forget.
We finished practice, I got the guys in the dugout, and hey guys, this was just released. And really one of the few times I can ever remember just not knowing what to say.
We were told, hey, this is it, there's no spring championships. And then we were sent home.
The team finished the shortened season with an impressive 11-5 record, including a three-game sweep of third-ranked Georgia.
Yeah, we sweep Georgia. That's great. And everybody was talking about it. And it was a good thing. I'm not taking anything away from that. But if we don't focus on what's in front of us, Tennessee coming in here, then you know we're not setting ourselves up for success.
19th-ranked Tennessee, one of the many big opponents on the Eagles' full 56-game schedule this spring.
We're looking forward to playing someone else besides ourselves, and we've really got a lot of energy and momentum moving forward.
The Eagles entering 2021 with its biggest roster in program history. The NCAA granting an extra year of eligibility to all student-athletes in spring sports who lost their seasons last year.
Getting that extra year of eligibility, I know myself and my teammates, we're not taking anything for granted. We saw, you know, the entire season get taken out from under us. And I think it was a wake-up call for a lot of us that this game can be taken away from us at any point.
Georgia Southern will open the season playing 13 of their first 16 games at J.I. Clement Stadium in Statesboro. First pitch set for February 19th against Tennessee. Reporting in Savannah, Amy Zimmer, WJCL 22 News.